time, Emma.
Miss Fordham's class presents the Hermit Crab play.
Time to move. I'm going to be for the show.
Hermit Crab had felt safe and snug in his shell, but now it was too snooky. Stepped out of the shell and onto the floor of the ocean. But it was frightening out in the open sea without a shell to hide it.
What if the fish comes along and attacks me? I must find a new house soon.
Early in February, Hermit Crab found just the house he was looking for. It was a big shell and strong. He moved right in, wiggling and wiggling about inside to see how it felt. It felt just right.
But it looked so well, so clean. In March, I met some seniors. They swayed back and forth in the lawn. How beautiful you are. Would one of you be willing to come and live on my house? It's so pretty, it needs you.
I'll come and make your house more beautiful.
Gently, Hermit Crab picked up the scenery with his claw and hit it on his shell. In April, Hermit Crab asked a flock of starfish, moving slowly along the sea floor.
How handsome you are. Would one of you be willing to come and decorate my house?
I would like to decorate your house.
Carefully, Hermit Crab picked up the starfish with his claw and put it on his house. In May, Hermit Crab discovered some coral. They were hard and didn't move.
How pretty you are! One of you be willing to make my house more beautiful?
I will make your house more beautiful.
Gingerly, Hermit Crab picked up the coral with his claw and placed it on his shell. In June, Hermit Crab came to a group of snails crawling over a rock on the ocean floor. They grazed as they went, picking up algae and bits of debris and leaving a neat path behind them.
How tidy and hard-working you are! Would one of you be willing to come and help clean my house?
My friends have been so good to me. They are
goodbye.
I couldn't stay in that little shell forever.
The ocean's full of hiding and hurry up and ready. But Hermit Crab wasn't afraid. She was